closing your eyes and then just allowing your body and your mind to relax as you listen to my voice. The more relaxed your body becomes, the more relaxed your mind becomes. And the more relaxed your mind becomes, the more relaxed your body becomes. It's almost like, was it perpetual motion? It's a case of just letting go, especially letting go of those thoughts in your mind. So the first part of this recording, in fact the majority really, is about relaxation, which then leads to sleep. So if you're listening solely for relaxation, there's a chance you may fall asleep. So perhaps set a nice gentle alarm to wake you up if you need to be somewhere. Versions of this recording, one without, one with music supplied by Kevin MacLeod, and his details, his website and the copyright information will be in the description box of the recording. Most important thing really is to just allow yourself the time to prepare. Paper or a pad and write down that particular issue in order to remind yourself of it when you're finished with this recording. Now, pretty certain that if it's an important thing, you'll still remember it when this recording is finished. I mean, the one thing that this doesn't do, it does not delete your memory. Empty your mind, just like you may empty your house, but you don't forget the people that were in your house, at something, which is quite a good analogy, really, in the sense of fussiness and the reality that, well, I can put it in a question. Are you fussy who you allow in your home? Do you allow people that you don't want in your home to enter? Do you invite people you don't like into your home? So when it comes to thoughts, what thoughts do you allow into your mind? And why? What thoughts do you allow into your sleep deeply, and why do you allow some of those thoughts that are distressing, uncomfortable, and let's face it, some thoughts are just very unkind and rude to us, almost bullying us at times. Why you wouldn't allow that in your home? So why allow it in your mind? Now I understand that, you know, someone may be a lot stronger, so, you know, might be having a party, someone turns up that you don't want in your home or at the party, but it's hard to get rid of them because they're a handful. Just hope to leave eventually without causing too much damage. And it may be because they're just too strong, too big, too intimidating, perhaps. The thing is, in our mind, there's no such thing as a thought that is too big for us. No such thing as a thought that is too intimidating for us. No such thing as a thought that is too much of a bully for us, that we can't do something about all of those things because we don't have to allow them to spend time in our mind. it's also